Hello, in this video we are going to study the auxiliary boiler. Throughout these units, we have seen that the main problem in a PT-CSP plan is that the electrical production and the electrical consumption of the people must match. That is, if we generate some energy in the plant, the people must consume this energy at the same moment. As we saw in the unit 2.3 thermal storage, it's impossible to store electrical energy because you cannot stop an electron. In fact, a battery is based on a chemical reaction that transforms this chemical energy into electrical energy. For that reason, a natural auxiliary boiler was considered in the six plants in California 80 years to adjust the production of energy in a PT-CSP plant. That is, imagine that you have designed your plant for 1000 megawatts per meter square of irradiation, and right now you have 900, so your PT-CSP plant is going to produce less energy than you expected. So the natural auxiliary boiler must support some energy, some temperature to the HTF to let operate the plant in under nominal conditions. For example, here we can see an example of electrical energy in Spain. And here this is the electricity demand, solar production and wind production. As we saw, the electrical production and electrical consumption must match at the same moment. However, an auxiliary boiler is going to produce more energy than wind energy or solar energy, so it's not paid at the same level. For example, imagine that you produce 1000 megawatts of thermal megawatts with this auxiliary boiler. You are not going to sell these megawatts in the same market than the megawatts produced by the solar field. In fact, you are going to sell this in the general market. On the other hand, we have that in addition to this energetic function, that is to increase the HTF temperature to let operate the plant under nominal conditions, you have the antifreeze function, that is to provide enough heat to avoid the HTF freezing temperature. The HTF freezing temperature is more or less 12 degrees. If the temperature is equal or below or even close to this temperature, the pumps maybe can break. For example, here you can see an example of three natural auxiliary boilers in vertical position. Now we must see the different positions of this natural auxiliary boiler throughout the history. The origin of this auxiliary boiler is in six plant in California in 80 years, and the first position was coupled to the steam generation train. So it was the function was overheating the steam. However, in this case, the hybridization is complete because the steam turbine in a PT-CSP plant must have overheated steam at its input. If we haven't got overheated steam at its input, we're not going to operate in the plant. So if the auxiliary boiler is not able to produce overheated steam, the plant is not going to operate. For that reason, in the SEX2 plant, the auxiliary boiler was changed. Its position was changed. In this case, the now supplies to the high pressure turbine, and the low pressure turbine is powered by the heat from the solar field. For example, here you can see an example of this. The auxiliary boiler is located here and is going to feed to the high pressure turbine. Now we have a third possibility, and this is in the SEX7 plant. The auxiliary boiler was considered in the same position, that is, it's going to supply overheated steam to the high pressure turbine. However, the low pressure turbine is fed by the reheated steam from the output of the high pressure turbine. So the final position of the auxiliary boiler is going to be considered in 6, 8, 9 and 10 plan, and this is in the thermal oil circuit instead of feeding to the steam turbine. And this is because of a very, very important reason, because if you locate, if you place this auxiliary boiler in the thermal oil circuit, you are going to increase the efficiency of the remaining equipment of the plant. Instead of, if we have got the auxiliary boiler feeding the steam turbine, you're going to increase from the steam turbine to the end, that is the water steam cycle, and the generator. But if you locate in the thermal oil circuit, you are going to increase the steam generation train, the solar field efficiency, because you are going to increase the temperature of the HTF at the end of the loops and the generator. So in general, the efficiency is more increased. For example, here you can see an example. The auxiliary boiler is located in the thermal oil circuit. And here is the same, the backup system, the auxiliary boiler, is located in parallel with the thermal oil circuit, in parallel with the mirrors. However, with this second placement, that is, the auxiliary boiler is in the thermal oil circuit, you are transforming this PTCSP plant into a conventional fossil fuel power plant. So there is a drawback, there is an inconvenience, because the energy produced by the auxiliary boiler is not paid at the same level than the energy produced by renewable energies. And this is very compressible because nowadays, with the environmental concerning, the energy produced by gas or fuel is not paid at the same level, because you are exhausting all the reserves. And for that reason, you must sell this energy produced by the gas into the daily market, not in the market of renewable energies. It's very obvious that the use of this gas is going to increase the yield, the performance of our overall plan. However, we have a limit, and this is that we cannot use this auxiliary boiler to produce energy. We can use to increase the temperature of the HTF to increase the renewable part of our PTCSP plant, but we cannot use as an individual equipment. For the previous reason, the main problem faced by these type of plants, that is PTCSP plant with auxiliary boiler, is the political framework. Because today there is not a clear law limitation of the technical use of this auxiliary boiler. And as we saw in the previous pictures, we have limited the use of this auxiliary boiler to increase the temperature of the HTF. But many companies are incapable, and they say, okay, I'm going to increase my temperature of the HTF with the generator stopped, so the production of this auxiliary boiler is not going to be computed in the production of the plant, but I'm going to increase too my speed of the turbine and some features that so we are going to operate when the generator turns on, instead of a waiting time to let operate the plant to increase the temperature of the HTF, etc. Now we must see the different kinds of auxiliary boiler depending on the power, because we are going to have two classes, two kinds of auxiliary boilers. For plants where the main function of this auxiliary boiler is to produce energy, the power is less than 50 megawatts, 50 thermal megawatts in Spain, although it's going to depend on the country. And for plants where the auxiliary boiler is not designed for this electricity production, but it's designed to avoid the avoid the freezing temperature of the HTF, that is antifreeze function, the power is less than 1 megawatt. If we have got an amount of HTF of 1,000 tons. For example, here we can see an example of the brand Atsu, and these are auxiliary boilers designed to antifreeze function. To finish this element, we must understand that nowadays some companies are researching in this possibility, and this is to incorporate, to place a gas turbine instead of an auxiliary boiler in the PTCSB plant and hybridize. So consider a thermal engine and have got a ISCC, that is integrated solar combined cycle. For example, here we can see an example of this gas turbine. So finally, you have successfully finished this element.